welcome to the 50th birthday celebration of Congress. What a fabulous party this is going to be. Nice to see everyone dressed up. You're all looking fine. For those of you that I haven't met yet, my name is Lindsay Drake Nightingale, and I'm your president of the Landscape Ontario Board of Directors. The theme for my term is defining the future, and what a theme to have during this auspicious occasion as our awards of excellence. Winning an award can define a company's future. Our green stamp recipients define the way forward to a better and more sustainable future. Collectively, these projects define our profession's future. Tonight, we will look back on the past 50 years, but it is the projects you see tonight that will make history. I predict that in 50 years from now, on the 100th anniversary, we will look back on this year's winners and see how the stage was set for the future of horticulture in Ontario. So it gives me great pride to congratulate all the award winners of all the award winners of 2023. Sorry, there seems to be a little issue. It appears that something important was forgotten at the office. So hang on, we'll be right back with you.
To the 50th Annual Landscape Ontario Awards of Excellence, a golden celebration of the best landscapes and horticulture work in the province. Welcome your host, in person for the first time, Carson Arthur.
Hey guys, I'm Carson Arthur, your host and apparently your delivery guy for this evening. I don't care. I'm just happy these prizes made it in one piece. Jaleesa, thank you. Big shout out to G&L Group for making this happen and for Joe the driver who fit that dump truck underneath that awning just beautifully. I mean, it's a live show, and it's a long time since we've done a live show, so things are gonna happen. But that's okay, because that's what makes this memorable. I am just so happy to be here, live and in person with all those guys. You guys excited? I can't hear you. Come on, give me some cheers. Oh, yes, thank you. Doesn't matter. We're still gonna make this memorable for you. Now, as you've probably figured out, we're doing things a little bit differently. You see, in the past, you would have gone in the back to get your award, but this year, you're gonna come out here. Jaleesa is going to give you your plaque, and then you're going to come on over here to this space. This is where you're going to do all of your photography. I mean, we lit it perfectly for you, so all your social media posts are going to look amazing. And for all of those award winners who maybe are going to pick up some hardware for multiple categories, first of all, congratulations. And no, you don't have to come here every single time. You can just do it once. Just make sure you pick up all of your awards before the end of the show, because in Landscape Ontario tradition, we're gonna take a big picture with all of our prize winners at the end. Now, I said to you, this is an important show. This is a big one. This is the 50th. The 50th anniversary of Landscape Ontario's Awards of Excellence, and I couldn't be more happy to be hosting this for you. Now, I had a chance to see some of the amazing entries, and wow, you guys blew it away this year. We're gonna be awarding prizes in the following categories: interior plantscaping, we're gonna do landscape lighting, design, marketing, maintenance, and of course, construction. And let me tell you, in the construction category, we had more entries this year than we have ever had in the past. And that's huge. I mean, we went through a pandemic, through supply chain issues, through price jumps that we've never seen before, and our customers stayed with us. It speaks to the strength of how good our industry really is. And let's not forget, we got four big awards to award tonight. We've got the second Neil Vanderkruck Award for Excellence in Design. We're gonna be giving away the Don Sullivan Award for Grounds Management. We're doing the Casey Van Maris Award for Innovation and Creativity in Design and Execution. And let's not forget the big one. This will be the 50th time we give away the Dunnington & Grubb. So grab yourself a glass of wine, maybe enjoy a cupcake, and let us entertain you. And I'm gonna go downstairs, I'm gonna pick up the rest of the prizes, but until then, I figure we should probably do this right. So let's kick off the show by me presenting to you Landscape Ontario's Executive Director, Joe Salemi.
Save the day, GNL Group. Thank you. Good evening, everybody. After 2 years of presenting Landscape Ontario's Award of Excellence virtually, we're finally together. Yeah. I've got to admit, I've been looking forward to sharing this night of celebration with you for a long time. It's been a dream of mine. Let's begin tonight by recognizing the work that Landscape Ontario does, as well as the work of its community members, takes place on traditional Indigenous territories across the province. We acknowledge that there are 46 treaties and other agreements that cover the territory now called Ontario. We're thankful to be able to work and live in these territories. We're thankful to the First Nations, Métis, Inuit people who have cared for these territories since time immemorial and who continue to contribute to the strength of Ontario and to all the communities across the province. Landscape Ontario, through consultation, has developed an initiative known as Reconciliation Growth. That puts action to our words. Through our members, Landscape Ontario will connect with every school in Ontario to plant a grove of trees, one for truth, one for memory, and one for hope. A physical representation. These will be places where students, faculty, and the community can gather and do the needed work for reconciliation. Tonight's ceremony is our way of honoring the best of the landscape trades. The show always fills me with inspiration and hope. Landscape Ontario's Awards of Excellence recognizes the stunning work of our members, provides marketing opportunities, and raises the bar for the entire industry. The awards program showcases your tremendous work to the broader community, including your own clients and potential clients. Congratulations to everyone that submitted an entry for judging. There's courage in entering, and that's truly inspiring. To all those that take home awards tonight, you make us proud. Thank you for your passion, your creativity, your skill, your commitment to the landscape trades. This is Landscape Ontario's 50th anniversary, and what a stellar time to be part of this world-class organization. Yeah. A few months ago, I spent some time with one of Landscape Ontario's founding members, Gord Shuttleworth. He shared his colorful history with me, underscoring the importance of knowing our association's heritage. This legacy will guide me and us as we enter the next era of Landscape Ontario. We're continuing to dedicate significant resources towards workforce development, recruiting new and passionate people, training them, connecting them with amazing employers in Landscape Ontario's community. We're driving forward with apprenticeship, This past year alone, we received nearly $4 million from the province to advance the landscape trades workforce development efforts, and have recently applied for much more. Our future will be bright. However, tonight, it's time to celebrate our present while taking a few fun peeks back at 50 years of excellence. Enjoy the show.
All right, I am back and I am excited to be here. There's so many faces that I recognize that I haven't seen except on Zoom media in a long, long time. Hey, everybody. All right, tonight's ceremony is possible because of the generous support of our show sponsors. Thank you for our longtime audiovisual partner, AV Canada. Our supporting sponsors include Conan Nurseries, In Light Outdoor Lighting, Site One Landscape Supply, Toro, and Unilock. And of course, our presenting sponsor, G&L. So, for all of you that have attended these events before, and you're wondering, yes, in fact, G&L will be giving away another one-week stay at Mount Tremblant. Somebody's gonna win that tonight, but you gotta be here to win it. Do we have any past winners? Has anybody gone to it yet? Yeah? Did you like it? How were the hills? Good snow? Yeah? More importantly, how big were the hot tubs? So you do it again? Nice, I think I would too. All right, I promise we're gonna be drawing from those ballots at the end of the show. You gotta be here to win it though, so keep your seats intact. All right, speaking of winning, it's time to reveal our first set of Awards of Excellence recipients. But before I do, remember, you're gonna wanna go to that photo booth after you win your award to both pick up your plaque and do that social media post. And I'm probably gonna be standing there waiting to talk to you. So here now are our winning entries for interior plantscaping and landscape lighting programs.
Interior Plantscaping Design and Installation. International Landscaping, Lush Luxury Hotel. Interior Plantscaping Maintenance. International Landscaping, Lush Luxury Hotel. Landscape Lighting Design and Installation. Under $10,000. Empire Green Lawn Sprinklers, Doty Street, Aurora. Groundhog Landscaping, Meadowvale Drive. Hanson Lawn and Gardens, Janet Way Lighting. Moonstruck Lighting, Private Art Gallery. Landscape Lighting Design and Installation, $10,000 to $30,000. Moonglow Lightscapes, Landscape Delight. Moonstruck Lighting, Modern Comfort. Landscape Lighting Design and Installation, over $30,000. Groundhog Landscaping, Oakdale Golf Club, Clubhouse. Kenneth Morgan Pools and Landscaping, Light the Way. Landscape Effects Group, Contemporary Paradise in the Evening.
Moonstruck Lighting, Kingly Vistas, OGS Property Services, Green Turf Irrigation Systems, Maple Ave, Balsam Lake, Landscape Lighting Design and Installation, Holiday Lighting, Moonglow Lightscapes, Traditional Warmth,
Inlight has created a unique line of high-quality, modern, beautiful outdoor lighting solutions. But it's not just about the products. It's about you. The visionaries who make outdoor spaces come to life. We've got the tools you need, but now it's your chance to make outdoor spaces unique.
Almost a year, and these are the beautiful plaques that you're going to be presenting to people today, kind of just like Carl, who's standing here. Carl, big congratulations, my friend. So which one of these is yours?
This one right here.
You got three of them, didn't you? Carl, big award winner this evening. So if I stole one, you wouldn't notice, right? Okay, well, I figure then I'll steal this one. This is for Hanson Lawn and Garden. Ed won't notice, right? All right, don't forget, when you get your prize, you got to come back here and pick it up. But up next, we've got a special award presenter that I am happy to introduce you to. It's my good friend, Scott Wentworth.
Good evening. Isn't this special to have everybody back together here tonight? Thank you. The Landscape Ontario Young Entrepreneur Award was created to recognize a member under the age of 35 for outstanding achievement in establishing and growing a successful horticultural business. Sean Christie from Rugged Earth Landscaping Inc. Sean has grown his small maintenance company into a multi-award winning enterprise. Working in the Muskoka region, the clientele expects exceptional service and workmanship. Sean has landed several high-end jobs because of his passion, knowledge of landscape design, and outside-the-box ideas. He's worked hard to train and retain his employees. I got to know Sean with Rugged Earth, took part in the Come Alive Outside Challenge, partnering with this community to get kids outside and moving. Sean Christie is an amazing example of what hard work can do for a company and just how fast a small business can grow. It is my honor to invite Sean Christie up to the stage to accept the Landscape Ontario Young Entrepreneur Award. Sean, congratulations.
Sean, you are exactly the example we want for all of our young people starting out in the industry, some of whom are actually backstage lined up right now. To present this year's student scholarships, please welcome up a legend, Mark Cullen.
Watching all this, and I'm wondering, am I the only person here tonight that remembers when our executive director was the most interesting person in the world? Am I the only one that remembers that? What I'd like to know is, how did the board manage to find a new executive director that's even more interesting? Thank you, Carson. Almost 50 years ago, the Ontario Horticultural Trades Foundation was founded by pioneers of this industry to help fund much-needed research. The foundation soon expanded its mandate to include the funding of scholarships in direct response to the sector's commitment to attract more young people to the industry. Almost $60,000 is now presented annually in the form of scholarships, bursaries, and awards to high school and post-secondary students enrolled in the field of horticulture. These awards are determined by available funding and the applications received. I'm delighted to bring up this year's recipients. We had 12 post-secondary scholarships. Please give a hand for our college university sponsorship recipients. Welcome up Ethan, Craig, and Melissa, our postgraduate scholarship winners. Also, the Casey Van Maris Memorial Scholarship was awarded to Abigail Merson. The Horace Dickard Memorial Scholarship presented to Sophia Bearden. And the Tony DiGiovanni scholarships, the most interesting man in the world, were awarded to Adam Funditis. He said it sounds like a disease. Funditis and Manuel Spiller. And my favorites, of course, the big hand to this year's Cullen sponsorship recipients. Congratulations to you all. We look forward to watching your careers progress in horticulture. Please consider making a charitable donation to the foundation so that it can continue to encourage and support the next generation of industry leaders. Thank you, everyone. Enjoy the rest of the show.
Discover where you can grow with free training from Landscape Ontario's Grow Program. Gouraud's new entrant training program prepares new workers for their first jobs in landscape and horticulture, while Gouraud's new worker job bank provides verified employers with priority access to the program's job-ready graduates. The Gouraud Supervisory Training Program helps current professionals, nominated by their employer, develop the skills and knowledge to assume a greater role within their company. And Gouraud's Employers of Choice program helps participants attract, recruit, and retain the best possible workforce. Visit Gouraud at Congress 2023 or go to gouraudoutdoors.ca to learn more.
This Employment Ontario program is funded in part by the Government of Canada and the Government of Ontario.
Hello again. Even before the pandemic exposed the province's shortage of skilled labor, Landscape Ontario was focused on finding ways to attract workers to the landscape and horticultural industry. Gouraud training programs support job seekers as well as current professionals to expand their skills through free training. It also offers, offers training to employers striving to enhance their ability to attract and retain the best possible teams. If you haven't checked out the program yet, I urge you to visit growtraining.ca and take advantage of these free programs. Since 2015, Landscape Ontario has been the Ministry of Labour, Immigration, Training and Skills Development's approved group sponsor for the Horticultural Technician 441C Apprenticeship Program. Landscape Ontario's apprenticeship team will support employers and apprentices through the entire apprenticeship process. I encourage you once again to visit the team at Congress Booth 757 to discuss the opportunities that are available to you.
Take your career to the next level. The Horticultural Technician Apprenticeship Program can get you there. Apprenticeship combines on-the-job training and in-class learning that leads to a Red Seal designation as a landscape horticulturist. Employers benefit from a stronger and more knowledgeable team while boosting job satisfaction and retention. Financial incentives and grants are available for both apprentices and their employers. Reach out to Landscape Ontario to learn how we can help you reach your career or business goals sooner than you thought.
Out there, it's every man for himself. Do more, do it faster, do it better. The work is tough, and building an experienced team is even tougher. The moment you've got the game figured out, everything changes. It's hard to know where you stand, but in here, you'll find your footing. It's a place that's as much a community as it is a store. A place where knowing you and your business go deeper than simply knowing your name. A place where the solutions aren't limited to what's on the shelf, and the experts behind the counter pride themselves on going beyond the call. In here, you'll find people who see eye to eye, who stand shoulder to shoulder, who work side by side to build things, great things. In here, you'll find common ground. We are Site One, stronger together.
The Neil Vanekirk Award for Excellence in Landscape Design will be presented annually to the most outstanding and highest overall scoring project from the design categories.
It is with great pride that we present the inaugural winner of this prize, named in honor of my father.
As soon as it came up, I was listening to the Vanderkrucks and talking about the award, and I was excited for design to have its category. The beautiful designs that are out there start with the idea and become what they are from the design. And so having it honored in this way, thank you. Thank you on behalf of, you know, all of us who put our hearts and souls into these designs. And I just was completely astonished. As soon as it came up on the screen, the TV, I'm like jumping up and I'm pointing. I'm going, that's my design. Oh my God, that's my design.
Hi, my name is Murray, and this is my wife, Jen, and we are in our Landscape Ontario award-winning backyard, courtesy of Rhoda Daru, our wonderful designer who has just created a marvelous space for us to enjoy every minute of every day, and we are thoroughly taking advantage of the work that she had done for us.
You're good at this.
I always tell clients right from the beginning that it is a collaborative process. I would not be able to do what I do if I didn't have clients coming forward, willing to invest in their landscapes and to be part of the process.
Having places hidden, which I don't think of as a gardener, I don't want anything hidden, but as you walk around, you notice different things. And I love that about the design of our backyard, that you can't see it all from one place, that you need to explore and wander through to see it. And she helped guide us through those concepts that we would otherwise be completely unfamiliar with.
When you're sitting in a garden with the birds, with the sound of water, with all of the lushness of the garden, that's what I really love. And I love the transformational aspect. So it is really a fundamental part of why I do what I do. I love coming into a space, seeing what's possible in, you know, creatively in my own mind and putting the elements together and then transforming the space. That's what I love.
Wow, that was absolutely spectacular. I mean, this is the best part of an award show like this. We inspire each other to do better, which is why I just want to be very clear here. That video was last year's award winner. I mean, there was some confusion during COVID and people got a little confused about when the awards were actually over. And people left their parties before they actually even won their award. Daru Landscaping. I promise this year we will present our top awards at the end of the show. Not in the middle, at the end. And when it comes to actually finishing off the show, you're gonna know when I'm done. Because I'm probably gonna say something like this.
Good night, everyone.
Good night, everyone.
Have a great Congress. Thank you and congratulations.
So, that's a good afternoon. See you later.
That concludes the Awards of Excellence for 1999.
Enjoy the next 3 days. Enjoy the next 2 days. Have a great time.
You guys, we want to say one thing. That was the 2006 Awards of Excellence show. Good night, everybody.
I want to thank everyone for being here and sticking it out for the full game. I'd like someone to get me a double scotch. Neat.
Have a great season in 2014. Keep going.
Everybody, have a great night. Have a blooming great year.
I'm out of here, Frankie Flowers.
We hope you had fun tonight. We had a little bit of fun ourselves. It was a special evening, but I'm sure you'll agree that it wasn't too over the top.
Now, hey, is that any way to end the show? I love your landscaping, Ontario. Hey, I'll show you how to end the show. That's right. All right, OL, here we go. Calling the train. I can't walk out because I love you too much, baby. Yeah, too much of it. Why can't you see? Oh, 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 what you do to me now, baby? When you don't believe a word I say.
Oh. Yeah, I can promise you now. There will be no Elvis costumes. I will not be coming out and doing a song and number. Thankfully, structurally, they couldn't hang a trapeze from this roof, so that ain't happening either. But you will know when the end of the show actually takes place. But to be here, you gotta sit tight. And I promise, there's lots you're gonna wanna see. So if you wanna know who's gonna win the Neil Vanderkruk Award this year, you gotta stay right till the end. What I can tell you, though, is that this year, The winner is going to be from one of the following winning projects in the design program. Now, this is a big award, so you want to pay attention to this one, because the judges took a lot of time and effort, and they judged the criteria on the following examples of overall design impact, problem solving, creativity and innovation, horticultural correctness, aesthetic appeal, technical hardscaping aspects, plant selection, organization, and completeness. And these designs didn't actually have to be built to qualify. So now let's reveal this year's Awards of Excellence in the Design Program.
Private residential design, under 2,500 square feet. Plantinence Landscape Group, simply irresistible. Private residential design, 2,500 to 5,000 square feet. Gelderman Landscape Services, Burlington Residence. Jennifer Heyman Design Group, Urban Spa. Private residential design, 5,000 square feet or more. Adele Pierre Landscape Architect, Follow the Flow. DeRue Designs, Lake Life. Websites. The Backyard Urban Farm Company. Gelderman Landscape Services. Groundhog Landscaping. Hank Deenan Landscaping. Lavish. Maple Ridge Landscapes. Social Media Marketing. Gelderman Landscape Services. Groundhog Landscaping. Mike's Landscaping. Plantinence Landscape Group. Wentworth Landscapes.
All right, I'm out here in the lobby. I wrangled Melissa here at the photo booth. Melissa, congratulations.
Thank you.
So what'd you win for?
A postgraduate scholarship.
Wow, you're a student. This is amazing. So what are you studying?
At the University of Guelph.
Okay, what program?
Masters of Landscape Architecture.
Nice. More importantly, do you have a job yet? Well, this is the right spot to get one. There's a lot of companies out here. If you're looking for a new student or a new employee, Melissa's available. All right, coming up next, we've got a big award. We got a big shout out. Somebody's already ready to hire you. Throwing business cards at you. All right, so our next special award, please welcome to the stage Prosperity Partners Program Manager, Jackie Hart.
Great night. Oh my gosh, these guys do it upright, don't they? Wow. Good evening. The Landscape Ontario Peer-to-Peer Network is a growing group of business owners and their key managers. I've seen time and time again the benefits of engaging with one another, mentoring and sharing wisdom, sharing challenges and successes. Surrounding yourself with success brings success, and leading others inspires leadership. Mentoring others brings mentorship, and asking tough questions brings great wisdom. Sharing challenges creates a sense of relief, knowing that you're not alone on your path as a business owner. The Landscape Ontario Prosperity Partners Peer-to-Peer Mentorship Award will celebrate this year members of the group who demonstrate exemplary mentorship throughout the year. I'm delighted to honor two wonderful mentors, both of whom continue to commit countless hours to their Landscape Ontario community, and particularly to generously mentor peers looking to better understand the federal sub-program. Please join me in congratulating Lindsay Ross and Carla Bailey. Please join me on the stage.
Good evening, everybody. My name is Kyle King. I am a member of Landscape Ontario Irrigation Sector Committee. The Landscape Ontario Water Conservation Award is a special honor that is given to a person, company, or an irrigation project that demonstrates water stewardship, conservation, and innovation while maintaining thriving landscapes. Each recipient of this award is selected by Landscape Ontario Irrigation Sector Group. Stephen Hernandez of Groundhog Landscaping has been in the industry for over 25 years. Known for his considerable expertise, Steve constantly strives to find the best irrigation solution for gardens and turf that also conserves water. Over the years, he has made a significant contribution to the success of irrigation industry by teaching seminars for Landscape Ontario and WISOP. Congratulations to this year's recipient of the Water Conservation Award, Stephen Hernandez from Groundhog Landscaping. I invite you, Steve, to come up to the stage.
Who could ask for anything more? Congratulations, Steve. So well deserved. As part of my duties tonight, it's my pleasure to have been asked to present the Landscape Ontario IPM Leadership Award to Gavin Dawson from True Green. Nominated by his peers, recipients of this award are selected by the IPM Symposium Committee. This award recognized a distinguished educator, representative of a company, municipality, or supplier who by their achievements in the turf and or tree industry has contributed uniquely to enhancing or promoting the future of our industry for mutual and beneficial gain. For decades now, Gavin Dawson has been a true leader for the lawn care and ancillary industries. He has been chair of the lawn care sector group, active in IPM, and volunteered for various other committees. He demonstrates a sense of professionalism and inclusiveness in everything he does. Congratulations to Gavin Dawson, recipient of this year's IPM Leadership Award. Come on up, Gavin.
Let's reveal the winner of the Don Sullivan Award for Excellence in Grounds Management.
All Weather Landscape Co. Limited for Kensington.
Well, we are in the middle of the city of Toronto. And we are near Bloor and Sherbourne. And it is a 5-acre property. The building takes about an acre. It's built into the ravine. This would never be allowed today. It's an oasis in the city. There are many committees in this building. We have library committees and caring committees and house committee and the grounds committee.
And then what want to increase in all the
She is the boss here. So she's really worked hard and developed with the garden committee members a plan of action. She's really passionate about Kensington and really makes all of this possible. We do walk-arounds, and it's a bunch of plant geeks just getting excited about all the possibilities that there are here.
It's a complicated site with ravines included, steep hills on the south side, and then this extensive green roof above the garage. It's a heated garage, and on 18 inches of soil, all these trees and everything are grown. I mean, it's amazing. Definitely a complex site, which needs to be expertly maintained.
Jordan and Jess have a lot of previous experience in the maintenance field. And Jess is a graduate of the Horticultural Apprenticeship Program. This is a daunting place. Every, Justin Jordan were handed a binder with a schedule and loads of paperwork and lots of details. So that, I think, is definitely intimidating for anybody.
The enhancement manager, Sarah, she is a horticulturist from Niagara School of Horticulture. So you feel completely confident that if you speak with her, she will understand and she will relate it in the proper way to the crew.
Yeah, there's lots of feedback. So the standards are set really high, which is something that I personally would like to espouse. So that just helps drive it home that much more for our people.
It seems to be like it's a family business. And they're all part of that family. And working with people like this is always the best way.
I've been working with All Weather Landscape for almost 16 years. Yeah, so it's been a while. Well, in this position, I am trying to help the next generation make this a career. I want people to appreciate the experience and the expertise it takes to make beautiful gardens.
In January or February, Sarah telephoned said, by the way, we won this award. So the whole building knew about it and they were delighted. We're delighted for All Weather too. They put a lot of work into it.
That I really appreciate about the Awards of Excellence program is that it really helps to elevate horticulture as a profession. Just to have that recognition that somebody appreciates and knows what it takes to get there. Like anything, it matters about what you put into it and what you get out of it. So this is definitely a career that I have no regrets about choosing.
Wow, each one of those videos reminds us over and over again how amazing we really are. But there is a bigger picture involved here. In fact, I need to speak about it because it's pretty important. Landscape Ontario will once again submit projects from our provincial award ceremony to the CNLA Awards program. Now, the three highest scoring entries from last year's Awards Excellence will compete against the best of the best in this country. So good luck to all of our members. Bring it home for us. All right, at this point, we're gonna move on to the maintenance program, and I know a lot of you are very interested in this one. To enter a project and to be considered eligible for an award, a company must have maintained the space for a minimum of 2 seasons. Our judges evaluated each entry on the following: originality, overall impact, quality of turf cut, edging and trimming, evidence of IPM, proper pruning, plant health and vigor. And a fun fact, you were immediately disqualified if there was a mulch volcano in any of your pictures. Yeah, right? Agreed. Okay, so let's stay tuned and please enjoy all of these volcano-free entries.
Multi-residential maintenance, under 2 acres. Reliable Care Premium Landscapes, Southampton's. Reliable Care Premium Landscapes, Tapestry. Non-turf maintenance. Strathmore Landscape Contractors, 1100 René Lévesque. Strathmore Landscape Contractors, 2001 McGill College. Strathmore Landscape Contractors, Complexe des Jardins. Strathmore Landscape Contractors, Place Ville-Marie. private residential maintenance, under 15,000 square feet. Shades of summer landscaping and maintenance, Lippe. Private residential maintenance, 15,000 square feet to 1 acre. Shades of summer landscaping and maintenance, the Cairns residence. Snyder Turf and Landscape Care, modernly formal. Private residential maintenance, 1 acre or more. Snyder Turf and Landscape Care, spacious and invigorating. Wentworth Landscapes, textural charm. Special interest maintenance, residential or commercial. International Landscaping, lush luxury hotel.
Is the Casey Van Maris Memorial Award winner.
Cedar Springs Landscape Group, for Wonderful in White.
My favorite element. I love the plantings in the front. From the road, it's a really stark white modern home. Then you've also got these softer elements, and I think that's what brings it down to kind of a human level where you actually feel comfortable being in the space. Even though there's that starkness, there's still these softer elements. I think we knew from the start that just given the property and the home and the kind of unique design elements that we had, we knew that this was kind of an award winner. It was just something that walking into the space, it's not stuff that you've seen before, and so we knew that it was worthy of being submitted, and we were honored when it won the Casey Van Maris Award. The first time for us to win one of the top awards, to be recognized in the top categories, especially as a designer for one of the kind of design-centered awards, it's a really good feeling, and it's really rewarding. The time and the effort that this project kind of took and all the unique ideas. We definitely had to bring the white from the inside and exterior of the home into the landscape. And so we did that, you know, in the tile, in the stucco finishes on the outside. But some of the realities of that is that, you know, in Ontario, trees drop their leaves, there's pine cones, there's pine needles, there's birds that go to the bathroom. The learning experience there is that I think white is maybe better used in vertical surfaces as opposed to on horizontal. I love seeing spaces transformed. Aside from the mature trees, you know, there's some spruce trees along the side, some pine trees in the front, and a beautiful katsura in the back here. Those were maintained, but otherwise, all the plant material here was new. There was a woodland element that the client wanted to incorporate, especially in the side yards there where the boardwalks were. So that was kind of the driving force for a lot of the plant material. More natural and kind of serene. Again, just trying to offset that more stark modernness that we had with the home. And that's what kind of drove a lot of the plant material that we picked. This project here is really exciting because it doesn't look like just projects that you're used to seeing and the elements that you're seeing. It's more of a kind of international design in the sense that, you know, we've got Scandinavian inspiration, we've got kind of Miami Vice, we've got all sorts of different elements that we're pulling from. And so even though we're just in an Oakville backyard, I mean, we could be anywhere in the world. For myself, I'd love to be able to keep pushing the boundary and to create spaces that, yeah, just kind of take you away.
Nice job. Oh, hey, look, there's the lobby. And people are getting alcohol. That's why the room got quiet all of a sudden. They're all out there lined up. This is where your yahoos are. All right, don't forget to visit the winner's booth for all of our winners, especially in the maintenance program. Congratulations to all of you. You deserve a huge round of applause. As I mentioned earlier, we're showing you videos of all of our past winners, and we've seen a few. We took you out to Kingston, where Creative Design Solutions from Daru Designs, our first ever Neil Vanderkruck Award, were on display. Hiding up just from busy Bloor Street, we found an urban oasis lovingly maintained by All Weather Landscape, winner of the Don Sullivan Award. Cedar Springs, dramatic white landscape in Oakville, was filmed during one of the hottest days of summer, which is a real testament to why they won the Casey Van Maris Award. And soon, we're gonna take you to Collingwood, up north, so you can see the first, or find out firsthand why the Dunnington Grub winner was the Landmark Group, because they created that unforgettable pool. So who will claim the top spots this year? Well, we're about 30 minutes away from finding out. Let's now begin the construction program. And I know that's a big one for most of the people here because it had so many entries. You put the judges to work. This year, the judges marked on the following criteria: originality, harmony of design elements, integration of plants and material craftsmanship, horticultural correctness, site challenges and solutions, unique use of plant material, and the overall quality and impression of the work. And this year, I'm gonna tell you right now, the judges were very, very focused on building code violations. Right? So let's reveal the awards of excellence winners.
Balcony or rooftop garden. International landscaping. Lush luxury hotel. Oriole landscaping. Toronto Sky Garden. Proscape land design. Chartwell. Special Interest Construction. A Bloom Landscape Contractor. The Eaglehead Project. Elite Concrete. Kleinberg Paradise. Elite Concrete. Heath Heaven. Frontier Landscapes. The Phone Booth. Griffith Property Services. Modern Edge. International Landscaping. Lush Luxury Hotel. Land Art. Lakeside. Maple Ridge Landscapes. Let's bring this outside. Maple Ridge Landscapes. Blissburger Bar and Grill. Niagara Outdoor, California Dreamin'. Oriole Landscaping, working in the garden. Proland Landscape Construction, Poolside Cabana. Theme Gardens. International Landscaping. Urban Pavilion Harvest Garden. Lavish. Hobbit House Plantings. Water Features. Jackson Pond. Plunge Pond Party. Jackson Pond. Swim Pond Paradise. Lavish. A woodland oasis natural swim pond. Lavish. Dibbitt's Waterfall. Quiet Nature. Over the top in Hidden Valley. Quiet Nature. Resort-style natural swimming pool. Quiet Nature. Greenfield Stream. Woodland Landscape Construction. McPherson Waterwall. Zeng Landscaping. Detailed all around. Commercial Construction. Multi-residential and industrial, $10,000 to $25,000. Shades of Summer Landscaping and Maintenance. Cat's Law. Commercial Construction. Multi-residential and industrial, $25,000 to $50,000. The Backyard Urban Farm Company. Hayden Solomon's Memorial Garden. Commercial Construction. Multi-residential and industrial, over $250,000. Bienenstock Natural Playgrounds. Bernie Morelli Early On Natural Playground. Oak Ridge Group. Andrew Warburton Memorial Park. Oak Ridge Group. Valley Park Community Center. Oak Ridge Group. Windfield Park. Oriole Landscaping. The Royal Revival. Residential Construction. $10,000 to $25,000. Oak Ridge Group. Welcome Home. Shades of Summer Landscaping and Maintenance. The Brown Residence. Residential Construction. $25,000 to $50,000. Action Home Services. classic times modern meets. Action Home Services, DeVos. Hanson Lawn and Gardens, Fanterra. Hanson Lawn and Gardens, Center Park. Residential Construction, $50,000 to $100,000. A Bloom Landscape Contractor, The Putman Project. Action Home Services, Californian Vibe. Action Home Services, a cool one, please. Action Home Services, Bassinet. Action Home Services, Party in the Backyard. Action Home Services, Georgian Spectacle. Action Home Services, Stramazzone. All Weather Landscape, Briar Hill. Desjardins Landscaping, Windswept Farm. Gelderman Landscape Services, The Tool Residence. Infinite Possibilities Group, Lawrence Park Poolside Retreat. Kenneth Morgan Pools and Landscaping, creating curb appeal. Kenneth Morgan Pools and Landscaping, design made possible. Maple Ridge Landscapes, there's always time for pizza. Niagara Outdoor, Lincoln Marble. Oak Ridge Group, Summer Lovin'. Plantinens Landscape Group, Modern Elegance. Rugged Earth Landscaping, Woodland on Wood Street. Wood Bully, Zero Maintenance Resort.
With a landscape that simply and beautifully demonstrates what it means to have all its elements in harmony. let's reveal this year's best construction project.
Landmark Group for Tranquil Hideaway.
I met these clients 4 or 5 years ago. They had recently bought this property. It's an old log cabin with some pretty cool additions put on it over the years, and they wanted to create something just magical, something awesome. I think it speaks to just the quality of work and the creativity that we put into each and every job. It's not that we necessarily go out to win a Dunnington Grub, but it's a culmination of a lot of hard work, and it means a lot to our staff to be recognized by an industry and many peers for kind of what we like to say, thinking outside the box. It's something we always think about to remain an industry-leading company. So for us, that means definitely not cutting corners and staying up to date with the latest trends and sometimes it pushes the boundaries of what's typical.
When I saw it, I was pretty excited because, like, we've done pools in the past, but nothing quite this intricate or interesting. The gunite pool, and it was formed around the back of those rocks, and then we had to use some of the pool real estate to incorporate those boulders and raise them up over the pool wall that was existing already. And we had to make sure that behind there, we filled it with mortar and concrete so that there's no dead spots for the water to sit and get contaminated. So with those fountains, we had to make sure that we ran all the plumbing through the wall, so that was a challenge in itself around the masonry. And then making sure that they're all nice and level. And also the amount of water that comes out of them has to all be the same, consistent. So that's run through a series of valves. So that takes a lot of trial and error, just to make sure we get that consistent.
You know, achieving this sort of wild, rural look, but also, you know, getting the privacy and capturing the views and having that multi-season interest. I've been here a few times over the past few years and really, really happy with how it's all coming in.
The future of Landmark is to continue to provide the same level of service and quality that our clients and our peers have been known to expect with Landmark, but to keep pushing the boundaries, to be able to work with some really awesome clients and just really work with the natural landscape and see what kind of projects we can pull off.
Wow, after just seeing that lineup of incredible projects, I realized two things. One, I'm the same age as the Dunnington Grub Award, which is not necessarily a good thing, and two, when I started my career, I was excited when I got a $20,000 budget. Look at us now, right? You remember those days. Well, that's what this is all about. There have been so many great memories around this awards ceremony over the years. I mean, awards night is more than just a celebration of our industry. It's also a time to remember. So we're gonna do just that right now. So let's take a moment to remember those who aren't with us today. Our industry professionals, the friends, the families, and the colleagues that we've lost in the last year.
Thank you. Now, if you were paying attention to that last video montage, you probably noticed that there was some stuff missing. In fact, the most entered category this year was in the construction program under residential construction, the $100,000 to $250,000 projects. Our next presentation are just the winners of that category alone. So get comfortable and let's enjoy the show and all of these stunning awards of excellence winners.
Residential construction, $100,000 to $250,000. A Bloom landscape contractor, the Willingdon Project. Balsam Creek Landscaping, the Gulliger Residence. Balsam Creek Landscaping, the Wepler Residence. Boss Landscaping, Buchan Contemporary Cornerstone. Boss Landscaping, Bringleson, Dundas Valley Dreams. Cortland Landscape and Grounds, Brown's Oasis. Earth Art Landscapes, Tamarack Lake Cottage. Earthscape, Patio Lanterns. Earthscape, Pretty in Porcelain. Elias Stone Kings, Rose Garden. Garden Glen Landscape Construction, McNiven Project. Gelderman Landscape Services, the Behe Residence. Granite Park, the Chachi Residence. Granite Park, the Groomsbridge Residence. Granite Park, the Agarwal Residence. Granite Park, the Hutter Residence. Griffith Property Services, Simple Elegance. Griffith Property Services, Hillside Hideaway. Griffith Property Services, Timeless Beauty. Higgins Hardscape, the Guildwood Project. Hogan Landscaping, Poolside Paradise. Hogan Landscaping, Formal Front Yard. Infinite Possibilities Group, Dazzling Don Mills Makeover. JC Landscaping, Front Luxury. JC Landscaping, Orangeville Oasis. JC Landscaping, Richmond Estate. Jonathan Robert Landscapes, Urban Oasis. Kenneth Morgan Pools and Landscaping, Endless Elevations. Kenneth Morgan Pools and Landscaping, Tayside Dreams. Kenneth Morgan Pools and Landscaping, Weekend at Steve's. LandCon, St. Mark's. LandCon, Palm Drive. Maple Ridge Landscapes, Summertime and the Living is Easy. Maple Ridge Landscapes, a place for everything. Maple Ridge Landscapes, Muskoka Vibes. Mike's Landscaping, Sand Lake Serenity. Niagara Outdoor, Cully's. Niagara Outdoor, Jacob's Landing. Oak Ridge Group, Vintage Restoration. OGS Landscape Services, A Backyard Escape. OGS Landscape Services, A Break from Everyday Life. Planet Green Landscapes, Golf Links Estate. Planet Green Landscapes, Farm Country Oasis. Planet Green Landscapes, Dundas Retreat. Planet Green Landscapes, Parker Avenue Modern. Poolcraft, Bloomfield. Poolcraft, Scrivener Sunsets. Poolcraft, Bedford Beauty. Poolcraft, every squire's inch. Poolcraft, Gar Lehman. Precision Landscaping, Little Big Paradise. Precision Landscaping, Backyard Legacy. Pretty Landscapes, Sunset Bay. Proscape Land Design, Riverside. Proscape Land Design, Denessel. Proscape Land Design, East Heart, Front. Quiet Nature, McBay Paradise. Retreat Landscape Design, Hemlock Court. Scenic Stone Landscape and Design, Date with the Estate. Scenic Stone Landscape and Design, out with the old, in with the new. Scenic Stone Landscape and Design, expanded living. Shades of Summer Landscaping and Maintenance, Riesling Court. Silver Fern Landscaping, an evening affair. Streamline Irrigation and Landscape Services, Night's Watch. Streamline Irrigation and Landscape Services, October Skies. Streamline Irrigation and Landscape Services, The Big Break. Terra Opus Property Services, Sports Night. Terra Opus Property Services, Family Paradise. Terra Opus Property Services, Peaceful Retreat. The Imry Group, Hennessy House. Three Seasons Landscapes, Suburban Retreat. TLC Professional Landscaping, outdoor entertainment heaven. TLC Professional Landscaping, the ultimate poolside retreat. Wentworth Landscapes, poolside living. Wild Ridge Landscapes, on Lake Time. Whispering Pines Landscaping, views and vistas. Willow Landscape, Cherry Hill Crescent.
If you were paying attention in that last video block, there were 77 winners. So massive congratulations to all of you. And the best part is, we're not even done the construction part of the show yet, right? But to break things up a little bit, I thought, you know what? Let's have some fun. Who's ready to go to Mont Tremblant? Yeah, let's do it. Woo! All right, let's bring up Andrew Abels, GNL's Vice President of Sales and Marketing, and a big, big box of balance. All right, Andrew, can you explain to everybody what they're going to win tonight?
So tonight, hopefully everyone had a chance to put the draw in as you checked in. We are drawing for a one-week stay of Mount Tremblant in a luxurious, a three-bedroom condo.
And I need to remind you, if your name is called and you're not here, I'm taking your trip. All right, let's do this.
Okay, here we go. This is Patrick Cutts from Strata Identity.
Patrick, are you here? Patrick's here. Come on up.
Buddy. Come on up, Patrick.
Congratulations, Patrick. Just a reminder, there are three bedrooms in that condo, and if you have extra space, I mean, I could go. That'd be all right. All right, let's move on to the final awards in our construction program. And you guys, you're allowed to cheer when your company comes up, so feel free to go for it. And the winners are...
Residential construction, $250,000 to $500,000. Cedar Springs Landscape Group, The Kingsway. Cedar Springs Landscape Group, Bishop Court. Cedar Springs Landscape Group, Elton Park Drive. Cedar Springs Landscape Group, Trailview Drive. Cedar Springs Landscape Group, Fogarty Street. Cortland Landscape and Grounds, Freeman's Paradise. Creative Concepts Landscaping, The Orkney Getaway. Earthscape, Quite Naturally. Eden Garden Works, Taste of Savannah. Elias Stone Kings, Honey Bee Oasis. Gelderman Landscape Services, The Kemp Residence. Griffith Property Services, In the Hills. Higgins Hardscape, The Muirfield Project. Jonathan Robert Landscapes, Osmond Daily Retreat. Kenneth Morgan Pools and Landscaping, Our Private Getaway. Kenneth Morgan Pools and Landscaping, Living in Paradise. Kenneth Morgan Pools and Landscaping, Summer in the Six. Kenneth Morgan Pools and Landscaping, let's entertain. Kenneth Morgan Pools and Landscaping, restoring the dream. Land Art, Merit. Land Art, Acres. Land Art, Sam. Land Art, Eastdale. Landscape Effects Group, Contemporary Elegance. Landscape Effects Group, Contemporary Oasis. Landscape Effects Group, Natural Elegance. M.E. Contracting, Heath Street. M.E. Contracting, McAllister. Michael Scott Landscaping, Simcoe Serenity. Niagara Outdoor, Distillery District. Planet Green Landscapes, Taylor Road. Planet Green Landscapes, 51 Sulphur. Planet Green Landscapes, Westdale Road. Planet Green Landscapes, Iroquois Avenue. Planet Green Landscapes, The Loder Resort. Poolcraft, Cedar Point. Proscape Land Design, Oak Hill. Proscape Land Design, East Heart, Back. Proscape Land Design, Balsam. Proscape Land Design, East Court. Quiet Nature, a natural zen. Silver Fern Landscaping, Uptown Fun. Stone Life Landscaping, Sweet Staycation. Three Seasons Landscapes, Mill Street. Three Seasons Landscapes, Valley Views. TLC Professional Landscaping, Whispering Pine Oasis. Wentworth Landscapes, Pool with a View. Wentworth Landscapes, Country Allure. Woodland Landscape Construction, McPherson Ave. Zhang Landscaping, Cohesive Vision. Residential Construction, $500,000 to $1 million. Balsam Creek Landscaping, The Cutlessa Residence. Cedar Springs Landscape Group, Elderberry Trail. Earthscape, Rural Backyard Escape. Earthscape, Structured. Griffith Property Services, A Country Glen. Land Art, Bartlett. Landscape Effects Group, Ultra Modern Living. Landscape Effects Group, Lakeside Magnificence. Landscape Effects Group, Contemporary Paradise. Oriel Landscaping, Urban Resort. Oriel Landscaping, Complete Relaxation. Planet Green Landscapes, Sulphur Springs. Pretty Landscapes, On the Rocks. Proland Landscape Construction, Welland. Proland Landscape Construction, Oriel. Proscape Land Design, Warren. Stone Life Landscaping, Cottage Oasis. Wentworth Landscapes, Fusion Prairie Retreat. Zeng Landscaping, True Blue. Residential Construction, over $1 million. Landscape Effects Group, a sophisticated space. Landscape Plus, special space. Silver Fern Landscaping, California Dreaming.
Oh, there's some people getting their pictures taken. Look at those smiling, happy faces out there at the photo booth. I can officially say, everybody, that is the end of the Construction Awards. Huge, amazing. You guys deserve a massive round of applause. Congratulations, everybody. All the different winners. You deserved it. And don't forget, go pick up your awards. That photo booth is hopping right now. All right, at this stage of the program, I want to talk about something that's very important to me, as well as to many of you as well, and that's great. I think it's fantastic. We're talking about the Green Stamp Recognition, which highlights those projects that prioritized green practices, sustainable landscapes, and best practices. Things like the use of permeable pavers, native plantings, water conservation strategies, and green roof technology. This year, once again, we want to give extra special recognition to the projects that actually earned Green Stamp Awards. So our first up, International Landscaping, receives 3 Green Stamp Awards for its project, Lush Luxury Hotel. They won the Green Stamp Award for maintenance, for plantscaping, and for construction. Wentworth Landscaping receives 2 Green Stamps for their same project, entitled under 2 names, Textural Charm in Maintenance and Fusion Prairie Retreat in Construction. Adele Pierre Landscape Architect earns a Green Stamp Award for design for the project, Follow the Flow. The Backyard Urban Farm Company receives a Green Stamp Award for construction of the project, Hayden Solomon's Memorial Garden. And Pretty Landscapes Incorporated is awarded a Green Stamp for construction for the project, Sunset Bay. And finally, Quiet Nature Limited receives a Green Stamp Award for construction for its water feature entry, resort-style natural swimming pool. There were also 3 projects that did not have enough points to win an Awards of Excellence, but they definitely deserve some recognition for their Green Stamp Awards. Adele Pierre Landscape Architect for Capture the Rain, Earthscape for Elmira Nature Reserve, Infinite Possibilities Group Incorporated for Something for Everyone, a multi-generational landscape. Next year, I want to see even more applicants, so that's on you. We can do this. Let's make it happen. All right. We're almost at the end, everyone. This is the part everybody has been waiting for. We're about to give one of our 4 overall prizes away. And let me tell you, to be recognized by one of these awards means that you are among the best of the best. And to be honest, we feel kind of bad that the award recipients from 2021 and 2022 didn't get their onstage moment. I mean, yeah, it's great, you won the award, but it doesn't feel the same when you're sitting on a couch beside your dog and your kids, or in your staff room and half the staff have already gone home for the night. So at this time, we're gonna recognize those award winners. And if they're here, we're gonna invite them up on stage to take a picture with us to celebrate their wins. So if you're in the room, when I say your name, come on up. From 2021, the Cultivated Garden, Parkscape, and Nature's Choice Landscape Construction. From 2022, Daru Design, All Weather Landscape, Cedar Springs Landscape Group, and the Landmark Group. Come on up if you're here. Or I'll just take a picture by myself. I mean, it's not the first time, right? All right, we got one. I'm not gonna keep you in suspense any longer, although I do have one fun fact. The Dunnington Grub Award has been around longer than Landscape Ontario. But that's not the award we're gonna start with this evening. This evening's first award has only been given away one time before. So tonight will be the 2nd award winner of the Neil Vanderkruck Award of Excellence in Landscape Design for 2023. Please welcome Mark and Brent Vanderkruck to present the award.
Harrison, good evening. The Neil Vanekirk Award is presented to the most outstanding and highest overall scoring project from the design program.
On behalf of our family, it is our honor to announce that the winner of the Neil Vanekirk Award for Excellence in Landscape Design is...
Jennifer.
So we'll take the award back to LO for her. Greg Sullivan could not be with us tonight, so I have the pleasure of presenting this year's Don Sullivan Award for Grounds Management. This award is given to the entry that achieved the highest overall score in the maintenance program and was created to give special recognition for the demonstration of superior maintenance skills that ultimately protect or even enhance the value of the original landscape investment. As you'll see, this year's winner beautifully exemplifies these criteria. I'm happy to reveal the Don Sullivan Award for 2023 goes to...
My name is Rob Brubaker.
And I am Cassie O'Neill. We are the grandchildren of one of the founders of Landscape Ontario, Casey Van Maris. I now own, and with the help of an amazing team, run Park Lane Landscapes, the company Casey started in 1958. That's 65 years ago. And Rob co-owns and runs Infinite Possibilities with my brother, Alex Zalewski.
Landscape Ontario presents the Casey Van Maris Award to the project that the judges deem to be the most innovative and creative from all the construction entries. On behalf of our family, I'm delighted to present this award to...
Come on up!
half a century, Landscape Ontario has honored the project that receives the highest overall score in the Awards of Excellence Construction Program with the prestigious Dunnington Grubb Award. This award is more than a trophy. It represents tenacity, leadership, entrepreneurship, skill, innovation, endurance, and superior talent. I'm extremely pleased to announce the winner of the Dunnington Grubb Award for this golden anniversary year is maintenance and construction. Scott and team from Wentworth Landscape, please come up and accept this award.
To have been part of such an emotional event. But more importantly, that's almost the end of tonight's show, everybody. We got a few thank yous to do. First of all, I want to thank, all the volunteer judges. They put the time and effort in. That montage was huge. They put hours to study and judge all of your amazing entries with some fantastic expertise. I want to also thank Landscape Ontario. Is grateful for tonight's supporting sponsors and our presenting partner, G&L Group. Thank you to LO's Director of Membership, Amy Buchanan, for ensuring this 50th anniversary gala would definitely be one to remember. We also want to thank Jennifer Howe, our show producer, and her team at Executed Events for another stellar production. And many thanks to Albert Graves of Bloman Decor for his design wizardry. And finally, a big thank you to the LO team, all the people behind the scenes. Shout outs to Mercedes, Jaleesa, Mike, Robert, and of course, Ian back there managing the live stream. All right, you know, don't forget, this isn't the end. There's some festivities downstairs happening right after this at the tailgate party, and apparently drinks are on Wentworth Landscaping. Yeah. Now, the best part about being together, we invite all the golden anniversary winners to come back to the stage. We're gonna do our group shot holding your plaques. So if you're a winner and you're in the room, come on up. That's it for me, your host, Carson Arthur. Thanks, everybody. Have a good night.
What da do, da da do, da da do.